السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، بلغ رسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين. أما بعد، my dearest brothers and sisters, inshallah we're going to be continuing our series of how to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the deeds of the heart. Today we're going to be covering one of the most important sections in this aspect, which is how can an individual or a servant increase his faith to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are some of the reasons that someone can do to increase his fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because this is something that, as we talked about, it is mandatory. It is mandatory as a Muslim that he should be fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And based on the definitions that we spoke about in the past, what is fear? Fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with knowledge, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in which that we go back to him, we don't run away from him, and etc. So today we're going to be talking about, my dear brothers and sisters, is what are some of the most important reasons that someone would need for him to increase his fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The number one reason, my dear respectful brothers and sisters, this is something that is almost obvious, that we need to increase our fear of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is for us to learn. It is for us to know the mightiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone knows the mightiness and he knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who is he eventually would increase his faith, will increase his fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we spoke about in the past, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Indeed, the most fearing individuals of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are who? Are the ones that are scholars, who are known for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you know, for instance, the magnificence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control, He's in control of how many heartbeats you have. He's in control of how many times you blink. He's in control of your surrounding. He's in control while you're driving. He's in control while you're flying. He's in control while you're eating. At any point he could say B and it be. At any point he could say for your heart to stop, I will stop. At any point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say for the food that you eat, for you to choke with it, he would make you choke with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in complete control. He is the all powerful. He is the Almighty. He's the magnificence. He's in control of everything. And with that knowledge, my dearest brothers and sisters, that by itself, it's enough to know the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dearest brothers and sisters, he says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. And indeed, people have not given the correct status to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have not. And in that day, in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the whole world, the whole earth, and the whole skies, all of them are underneath his arms. All the universe is underneath him. So with this knowledge, with knowing this, and knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control, you would know, you would respect him and you would know him. For instance, let me give you a quick example. Let's say for example that, you know, you work in a factory. And the more you know your boss, the more you would respect him, right? The more you get close to him, the more you know how much he knows, the more you know how much power he has over the factory, the more you would honor him and the more you respect him. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have the best of examples. When Allah, one time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this hadith, يُمَجِّدُ الرَّبُّ نَفْسَهُ أَنَا الْجَبَّارُ أَنَا الْمُتَكَبِّرُ أَنَا الْمَلِكُ أَنَا الْعَزِيزُ أَنَا الْكَرِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising himself and he is saying, I am the all-powerful, I am the all-arrogant, I am the king, I am the most honorable. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why is saying this? فَرَجِفَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. the Prophet ﷺ starts shaking, and the believers thought that Prophet ﷺ is going to pass out because of this. So Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he knows the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Prophet Muhammad ﷺ tells us this beautiful hadith, listen to this. مَا السَّمَاوَاتُ السَّبْعُ مَعَ الْكُرْسِيِّ إِلَّا قَحَلَقَةِ الْمُلْقَاتِ بِأَرْضِ فِلَاهِ. He said, if you want to compare all of the seven heavens, all of the seven heavens, and compared to the kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is like a ring thrown into the desert. A ring is thrown into the desert, it is the comparison of how much the seven skies in comparison to the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفَضْلُ الْعَرْشِ عَلَى الْكُرْسِي كَفَضْلِ الْفِلَاتِ عَلَى الْحَلَقَةِ. He said, and the kursi, the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you want to compare it to the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the same comparison. Like a ring thrown into the desert. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the most magnificent, the most powerful, the one who is in control. So that, my dear brothers, when we know about these things, when we realize these things, we know how small you are, you would know, you would respect, and you would fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A second most reason why an individual should be fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that every time you read the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, should be a reason for you to know more about Him. تدبر كلام الله, that you would not just read. Now we're coming into Ramadan. And unfortunately, many people are stuck into the theme of how many times have you read the Quran. Right? All of us are guilty of that. It's nothing wrong with reading the Quran 10 or 20 or 30 times. Nothing wrong with that. But the issue here is how much of that 10 times have penetrated your heart. Because subhanAllah, this is extremely important. Because Ibn Qayyim, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, this is what he said. فَلَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَنْفَعَ لِلْعَبْدِ مَعَاشَهُ وَمَعَادَهُ وَأَقْرَبُ إِلَى نَجَاتِهِ مِنْ تَدَبُّرُ الْقُرْآنِ. He said there is nothing is better for the servant. Nothing in this world better than the servant that would help him go through this dunya, this world, other than reading and contemplating on the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Jawzi, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, what he said. He said, وَاللَّهِ لَوْ أَنَّ مُؤْمِنًا عَاقِلًا. If there is a good, you know, mu'min who thinks correctly, and he reads Surah Al-Hadid, and he reads the end of Surah Al-Hashr, and he reads Ayat Al-Kursi, and he reads Surah Al-Ikhlas with thinking and with contemplation, unless his heart would open and would crack because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, you know, when you read these things, we read it with contemplation, not to when we start a surah, we think about its end. You understand? We don't, you know, a lot of us, when we read, we think, oh, I'm going to start a surah, let me think about its end, and etc. So this is very important, my dear brothers and sisters. When we read about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is the one who taught us how to be fearing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we increase our knowledge and we learn how we fear. My dear brothers and sisters, when we, common reasons to make us increase our fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at our deeds. Look at our deeds. Like for instance, when someone does a righteous act, have you feared if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to accept this act or not? Like after doing it, after we pray, after we fast, after we donate, after we cry, after everything that we do, have you thought, well, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept my deed? With that thinking, when you think about that, and you go back and see if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have really accepted this or not, it makes you wonder, and then you would say, you would make sure that you wanted to perfect this deed the next time. You want to make sure that you have elevated, you took a higher step next time. You don't say, you know, I've done it, you know, what else he wants? No, that's not the way you deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know? What else he wants from me? وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. No, you can't do this. You know, when we deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to deal with him with respect, with honor. Yes, Ya Rabbi, I have done this. I have given it to you on a golden plate. What else do you want from me, my Lord? This is the attitude that someone should be approaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would increase, and wallahi, I have tried this personally, and everyone should try this. You would increase your fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you think about the past sins. Many of us, my dear brothers and sisters, we sin, and you might remember the sins of yesterday. But when I ask you, what have you sinned last week? Wallahi, many of us, including myself, we forget, right? This is the reality. But when you remember them, and you realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have let you go, and you would realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have not punished you for it, and you would realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might have covered your own sins, ya Allah, wouldn't you increase your fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? All of you guys know Imam Ibn Sirin. You know, he's the famous dream translator, right? Okay. One time I want to give you a story of how righteous this Imam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given this Imam wealth at the end of his life. He became rich. And one time he used to sell oil. And he found, you know, and sometimes the oil become hard when you freeze it, right? When you freeze the oil in the winter, it becomes hard. So what happened? He opened one of the buckets of oil and he found the mice inside of it. So what happened? He did not know somebody pulled this mice out of this bucket of oil, and he did not tell him which bucket of oil that he pulled this mice from. So what he did, he threw all of his oil, because he did not know where it came from. So he thought that everyone could be poisoned, right? So when they asked him, what happened? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have punished me for a sin that I have committed 40 years ago. He's keeping track, unlike us, you know? He said, what have you done for 40 years ago? He said, one time I have mocked an individual and I told him, Ya Faqir, oh the one who is poor. He mocked at him. And he remembered that. He remembered that one time 40 years ago, he mocked at an individual. And he was just waiting as when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to punish him for this sin. What about us? Allah, Allah, Musta'an. So my dear sisters, yes, we commit sins left and right. And out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He covers ourselves. And He let us go. And He would not account us. And He would not punish us. But what happened? That should not increase us more than fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even more. And that's one of the things we need to think about, my dearest brothers and sisters. One of the things that we need to think about, what is going to be our ending? Wallahi al-azim, you would wonder, where are we going to end up? You know, once you die, and no one can guarantee death. Once we die, where are you going to end up, ya akhi? What is your destiny? And how are you going to die? Are you going to die in doing a good deed, or are you going to die committing a sin? When you think about death, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say the death that you are running away from the death that you are running away from is going to come to you. It's going to hit you no matter what. How are you going to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That in itself you should be fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell us, أكثروا من ذكر هذا من اللذات. Try to remember Allah. What? The destroyers of all pleasures, which is the death. Why? Because when we think about it, we become more fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We think about our destiny. Where are we going to end up? And how are we going to face Him? And that in itself, you became watchful. You would say, Ya Rabbi, I'm going to go to the movies. Or I'm going to die in the way. Ya Rabbi, I'm about to die. I'm about to lie. Why am I lying? Is that the way I'm going to die? Ya Rabbi, I'm looking at something that I'm not supposed to be looking at. Ya Rabbi, I'm going to die doing this. Ya Rabbi, I am praying and making Qiyam al-Layl. Ya Rabbi, take me in this position. Ya Rabbi, I'm fasting today. Ya Allah, I would wish that I would pass in doing such a good deed, and etc. You become more fearing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the practice. So you become more watchful in every steps that you do. My dear brothers, when we think about our destiny, where are we going to end up in the grave? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the past, he said, كُنْتُ قَدَّهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْ زِيَارَةِ الْقُبُورِ. In the beginning of the message, he forbade us from visiting the graves. He forbade all of us. He said, أَنَا فَزُورُوهَا. Now, go visit it. فَإِنَّهَا تُرِقُّ الْقَلْبِ. What does it do? When you go visit the graveyard, it softens your heart. وَتُدْمِعُ الْعَيْنِ. And it makes your eyes tear. وَتُذَكِّرُكَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. And he would remind you of the hereafter. وَلَا تَقُولُ هُجْرًا. And then it would get you closer to that to the scenery. What are you going to be expecting in that day, my dear brothers and sisters? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one time when he was sitting and people were preparing the burial of one Muslim, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ya ikhwani, limithli hadha fa'a'iddu." While they're preparing, burying him, that, oh my brothers, for this, you should be preparing. This is a fact that no one could run away from. Wallahi, all of us will die. Wallahi, all of us will die. This is all, whether you are Christian or Jews or atheist or whatever color or race that you, all of us agree that all of us will die. But the question is, where is it going to be your destiny, ya akhi? My sister, where is you? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to take you wearing the hijab or not wearing the hijab? Are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take you wearing makeup or not wearing makeup? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take you doing a good sin or doing a bad sin? Think about that. Because that in itself can increase our fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every time we realize what's going to be our destiny in the hereafter. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَاخْشَوْا يَوْمًا لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَازٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيْئًا إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. O people, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear a day when the father cannot do anything for his son, and the son can do anything for his father. Indeed, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the truth. So don't let this dunya fool you, and don't anything fool you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yeah, brothers, we in this dunya, we sacrifice ourselves for our children. Wallahi, when I go back home, I wanted to see if I see my children, it means the whole world to me. But in that day, they would run away from me, and you would run away from them. Subhanallah. So this is something that we need to think about. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the hellfire, and he said, إِنَّهَا لَإِحْدَى الْكُبَرِ. This is one of the greatest, this is the greatest fire that ever was made, was ever created. Many of us, if somebody lit a candle, we are fearful to put our hands on top of it. What about when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّهَا لَإِحْدَى الْكُبَرِ. It is the greatest fire that ever was created. And that's why when we see it, we forget everything. You know? When we see it, Al-Hasan al-Basri, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with it, but he said, ما أنذرت الخلائق بشيء قد أفضع منها. He said that all the creations were not warned if something worse than the hellfire. Nothing is worse. Nothing is as bad as the hellfire. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he saw it. Our beloved Prophet, when in his trip, he saw it. He seen the hellfire. He said, ما رأيت مثل النار نام هاربها. He said, I have not seen anyone like the fire, like the hellfire, and somebody sleeping and he does not think about it. Like, if somebody sees it once, he could talk about it all day. us, we believe everything is in the Quran, but it's nothing like seeing it. And that's the whole point, my dear respect brothers and sisters. When we think about my dear respect brothers and sisters, when we think about some of the people who were our predecessors and how they dealt and how they were feeling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it gives you an impression of how what's our shortcoming going to be. Like for instance, when we read what Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he says, هَذَا وَالَّذِي أَوْرَدِنِ الْمَوَارِدِ. He used to hold his tongue, Abu Bakr. He used to hold his tongue and he said, this is what got me into all of my troubles. He knows. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he used to put a stone in his mouth so he would talk less. يعني عمر خطاب رضي الله عنه, what he said is, يا ليتني كنت هذه التبنة. He said, I wish I was a planet, I was a tree. يا ليتني لم أخلق. عمر خطاب said, I wish I was never created. يا ليتني لم تلدني أمي. I wish my mother have never given birth to me. يا ليتني لم أكون شيئا. I wish I was nothing. He knows. He knows one day he's going to be counted for. He knows he's gonna be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything won't be discussed. And that's why he was fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني, when Uthman ibn Affan, he said, وَجَدْتُ لَوْ أَنِي لَوْ مُتْتُ وَلَمْ أُبْعَثُ. I wish that I've died and I was destroyed and I would never resurrected. This is the kind of thing that we need, my dear respect brothers and sisters. So with this being said, my dear respect brothers, we have to create an atmosphere around us in which that we are fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We choose friends who are fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهًا. And be patient with those who are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the day at night, they need nothing but His face, the glory of His face. That's why when you go, you choose a friend, you choose a brother, who's going to come bring you to the masjid, who's going to advise you. Nowadays, subhanAllah, you know the people that we hate? We hate the people who criticize us. We hate the people who tell us the amr bil ma'ruf wa nahi al munkar. We outcast them, we kick them out of our masajid. But rather, these are the people we should be chasing after. The people who tell us what is the right and the wrong. And this is the reality that we are living in. So subhanAllah, my dear brothers and sisters, you know, we have to make sure that, you know, practice this with our hearts. And that's the whole point. Once we practice this and we would have, as Ibn al-Qayyim have once said, you have an eye in your heart that is watchful of everything that you do, of your intentions, of the way you react, the way you talk, and the way you everything that you conduct in your life. And then after that, you would feel and you would practice the true fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I said anything that is good, isn't it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet? If I said anything that is appropriate from myself and Shaitan, جزاكم خير لاجتماعكم سبحانكم وحمدكم نستغفركم ونتوب إليكم العصر. إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خير من الله سبحانه وتعالى.